So I'm in my Tesla Model Y, and this morning I've just pulled up to a supercharger and my battery is at 18%. And I'm just going to see what the charging speeds are like this morning, because this has been preconditioning, but it's only been preconditioning now for 25 minutes, and it probably needs more like 40 minutes. But it's 10 degrees, was a bit colder earlier, so the battery pack's still going to be a little bit cold. So we'll just see what the charging speeds are like. So that's plugged in, and then up here we can see our charge speed of 47 kilowatt, and that's ramping up. So this car has the LFP battery, so this has a maximum peak rate of 175 kilowatt, so I'm not expecting it to get to that this morning because the battery is not at its optimum temperature. But actually, look at that, it has 173 kilowatt, so that's not bad considering it's still probably a little bit cold. There we go, 174 kilowatt. You can also see up there that we've got a 40 minute charge time, and that's because I've got the state of charge set to 100%. If I knock that down to, let's get it dead on 80% there, our charge time is 25 minutes. But because this is the LFP battery, it needs charging to 100% at least once a week. And I get free supercharging on this car. So today I'm gonna wait and I'm gonna charge that up to 100%. And it's quiet here, so I'm not hogging a stall. So I'm gonna give it the full, well, look at that, 35 minutes now. And it's now dropped down to 148 kilowatt, and it's adding 609 miles of range per hour. And obviously this car doesn't have a 609 mile range, but that's the rate of miles you're adding per hour of charging. But to fully charge this, it's only going to take 35 minutes. So it's now been 5 minutes, maybe 6 minutes, and the battery is already at 43% state of charge. The charging rate's now dropped down to 125 kilowatt, but we've added 13 kilowatt hours of energy in that 5 minutes. So while that's charging, I'm going to eat my porridge and watch a bit of YouTube. So it's been 20 minutes now and the battery is at 78%. And we can see here that during that time it's added 36 kilowatt hours of energy. It's now at 79% state of charge, but the charge rate's now dropped down to 53 kilowatt. But we notice here the it's saying it's still got 20 minutes remaining, and that hasn't dropped as it's been charging, because I think it was only saying 35 minutes when we started. So yes, the predicted time has increased a little bit, but anyway, we're now at 80% state of charge, and the majority of people are going to disconnect at this point and carry on with your journey. And to be fair, I would normally do that, but it's only because this is the LFP battery and you need to charge these to 100% about once a week, and it's only because I've got free supercharging and I've got the time this morning to sit here. So the remaining 20% is going to take as long as it has taken to get to 80%. What I find is even when this gets to 100%, it's got to do the battery cell balancing, and that can take another 5 to 10 minutes. But anyway, I'll include that on this video because some people might find that interesting. But that's something that the majority of EV drivers just wouldn't be doing on a DC rapid charger. I'm only doing that because I get free supercharging and I've got the time this morning, so I might as well sit here and let it do that, because it needs to do it once a week and I'm not hogging any superchargers, because there's now two cars down there by the looks of it. but there's, I think, 12 stalls here, so it's no issue sitting here full of full, what would it be, 40 minutes or so. And so we now got what it thinks is 13 minutes remaining. We're now at 84% state of charge already. It's now charging at 46 kilowatt. The charge rate's dropped down to 194 miles an hour. So it's still adding charge at a pretty decent rate. And we've added 38 kilowatt hours of energy already. And it's been, 20... what time did I get here? 20 past. So yeah, it's been 25 minutes. 24 minutes actually. So yeah, it's not bad, even though this is the slower charging rate Tesla. Because this, if this had the other battery that's on the long range or the performance models, then this would charge at a maximum of 250 kilowatt. But because this is the LFP battery, which they no longer make in the Model Y, this has a maximum charging rate of 175 kilowatt. But those charging rates are peak. It doesn't retain that peak rate throughout the whole charging. As you can see now, we're charging at 44 kilowatt. So in reality, there's not actually that much difference in the charge times on the standard range LFP, sorry, not the standard range, the rear-wheel drive LFP model versus the all-wheel drive long range. So in 25 minutes, this has added 40 kilowatt hours of energy, which is about 160 miles of range. So it's been half an hour now, and we are at 91% state of charge. So majority of EV drivers would have disconnected and carried on their journey by now. I'm sitting here as well with the heater going, and I've got my heated seat on, so that's consuming energy, but it's comfortable. So charge rate is now dropped to 36 kilowatt. We've added 42 kilowatt hours of energy. There's a little exclamation mark next to the charge rate. So if I click that, it's now giving us this message that the battery is nearly full. So we got a message there saying that the charge rate is going to drop significantly as the battery fills up. But majority of people wouldn't be doing this on a DC rapid charge. But I will let this continue so you can see what happens when you go above that 80 or 90% mark. But even at this high state of charge of 93%, we're still charging at 32 kilowatt there, which actually I think is pretty impressive. So as this battery fills up, obviously the charge rate is going to drop significantly and it's all going to start slowing down. But we're at 97, just clicked over there, 97% state of charge, and it's still pulling 25 kilowatt. So that is pretty impressive. That's still 100 miles of range per hour at that speed. And so far we've added 46 kilowatt hours of energy into the battery pack. And it's now predicting we've got 4 minutes remaining, which should bring us to 10:02, but I think it will be more like 10:12 by the time this is actually finished. 90% of the viewers of this channel are not subscribed. I'm sorry to ask, but it would help greatly if you would. Just press the subscribe button. It's free and it shows YouTube you like this sort of vehicle related content. If you want to be notified when new videos are released, please click on the bell button also. Thank you, it really helps more than you would imagine. But as I said, the majority of people wouldn't be charging their car to 100% on a DC rapid charger. It's a complete waste of time. And this morning, there's already been three or four other Teslas who have pulled in since I've been here, charged up and have left. And that's really the reality of DC rapid charging. Most of the time, it's a 15, 20 minute or half an hour charge at the most. But in my case, we're at 10:02 already. We're at 99%. State of charge, and it's still saying 2 minutes, so we've added 2 minutes already, but it's still pulling 11 kilowatt even at 99%. There goes the final remaining Tesla, and that's still 42 miles an hour, and we've added 47 kilowatt hours of energy into the battery so far. So in that time, there's now been four other Teslas who have pulled in after me, charged up, and have now left, because obviously they aren't doing this 100% charge. So we're still at 99%. It's been on 99% for a couple of minutes now, saying 1 minute remaining. As you can see, it's 10:05 now. So this is going to click over. There we go, it's saying calibrating now. So we're probably at 100% now. So it's finished the charging. It's still pulling 9 kilowatt though, so that's still more than you would get at your home. But it's clearly doing the calculating now. So I'm just going to let it finish doing that. So it's now been calibrating for 2 minutes and the charge rate's dropped down to 4, now 3 kilowatt. Now 2. So yeah, it's dropping very quickly now. And obviously that's because the battery is fully charged. So it's just clicked off. So that's been 6 minutes. We're now at 100% and it's finished the calibration and charging complete. And in that time, it's added 49 kilowatt hours of energy. So I can now disconnect that, swap hands and put that away. So I'll put up the charging stats on the screen because I can't remember now what time I started charging. But anyway, we're at 100% state of charge. If I click that, we can see that's going to give me an estimated EPA range of 258. So let's quickly talk about battery degradation, because when I bought this car, which is now just over a year ago, and in that time I have done 14,600 miles. That was 260 miles, I think. I'm going to look back on the pictures on the day I first charged it, when it was a couple of days old or so. So yes, we've lost 2 miles of range in a year and near enough 15,000 miles. But what happens with these is the battery degradation is more severe initially. It's not a linear downward curve. So initially, I think in about the first 6 months, they sort of drop off a bit, but then they flatline over the next 10 years or so. So a lot of new owners are a bit frightened by this, and they can see they've lost a bit of range, but actually that's now not going to change much at all over the next 100, 150,000 miles or so. But anyway, I don't have it on mileage, always have it on battery percentage. I think that's far more useful. And I hope you found that useful. If you have, please do click the thumbs up. That really does help. Do subscribe to the channel. And if you want to know more about the Tesla Model Y, in the video description below will be a link to a playlist where you can see other videos I made on this car. Okie doke, I'll see you on the next one.